Hey everyone, I'm NanoElite666, and you are watching me play Guild Wars 2! We are back with the fourth chapter of Season 3 of The Living Story, titled Head of the Snake! Quick recap on the last chapter, since it's been a few months since it. We were running around up north where it's cold and shit, and ran into Bram and Rox, trying to find a magic scroll that would maybe let him crack Jormag's tooth that's sitting in Holbrook, and Bram got really mad and had a grumpy, and words were exchanged, feelings were probably hurt, and Bram went back and set an arrow on fire from his bow, and stuck a flaming arrow in Jormag's tooth over in Holbrook. So, we're going to probably deal with none of that whatsoever today, because this chapter is going to involve the White Mantle. Looks like they are attacking Divinity's Reach. And remember, we were getting wrapped up with them in Bloodstone Fen in the first chapter of Season 3. Season 3. And we ran into Cauticus, found out he's the confessor, essentially the big boss of the White Mantle, and they brought back a Mersat. And then there were words exchanged between them as like, oh no, you're fake White Mantle. You're not true White Mantle. And apparently Lazarus ran off with a group of White Mantle that were more loyal to him than Cauticus. But apparently Cauticus and his flunkies are up to something. So let's get this show on the road, shall we? Now available to play, Head of the Snake. I wonder if it's in any way, shape, or form related to Brotherhood of the Snake. Queen Jennah has summoned you to an emergency gathering of the Ministry in Divinity's Reach. What are her plans for Kreta, and what role will you play in them? I don't know. But let's check our mail for an important message.
An invitation from the Queen herself. Timmy, do you read me?
Here, Commander. Oh, I must have nodded off there for a second.
I'm headed to Divinity's Reach to meet the Queen, but have you heard from Bram?
No, sorry. Rox got word through, though. Apparently she talked some sense into him. He formed an exploratory committee, let's say. They're making their way up to Jormag as we speak, to see what kind of damage they can do before mobilizing a larger force. I'm worried about him, Commander. He's calling this group Destiny's Edge.
I don't suppose Ritlock or Kaith had any say in that.
No. I don't want to lose into Jormag. And if we're right about its weakness, he won't stand a chance.
How are we doing on that front?
I have an idea. A great idea. Well, brilliant, really. But I need to complete the experiment with the samples, then reach out to some contacts to see if I can get what I need for the aforementioned brilliant idea. I'll keep you posted. Anyway, say hi to the Queen for me.
Do you know her?
I feel like I do, after all the gossip rags I read. Do you know she doesn't wear shoes? Try not to stare at her feet now that I told you that.
You're a huge help, as always. Get some rest.
Joke's on you, Tommy. We've known she doesn't wear shoes for, like, 4 years now. Anyways, back to reading the mail that was interrupted. A royal summons from QJ. Kira Bone Reaver, Her Majesty Queen Jennah of Kreta, requests your attendance at a festive meeting of ministers in the Upper City. Please make your way to the throne at your earliest convenience. Which actually means right fucking now. At your earliest convenience. Oh, okay, that's what it was. New Raid Wing. I don't care. I'm nowhere near being able to actually do raid stuff. So, off to Divinity's Reach we go! It's good that Rox has apparently managed to talk some sense into Bram. Because he was being pretty grumpy when we last saw him. Anyways, let's go visit this festive gathering of the Ministry. Continue your story, a meeting of ministers. Queen's got a sword.
illustrious leader of Dragon's Watch. Welcome.
I appreciate the sentiment, Your Majesty, but I feel like I haven't been much of a leader lately. I don't know how you do it. You have a whole kingdom to worry about, while I can't even manage to keep a handful of people driving toward one purpose.
It's a trying task, but to be honest, sometimes I envy what must be the simplicity of your life. This place is all politics and subtext. Do a thing one person likes and three hate you for it. It can get very complicated. You, you just relentlessly smash things until they're no longer at odds with you. I wish it were like that around here sometimes.
Well, what can I smash for you today?
I believe a White Mantle attack is imminent, and must take certain actions here in Divinity's Reach to ensure its safety.
The fact that you're not really describing these actions makes me think they might be a little unorthodox.
Yes.
What do you think of this garden, Commander?
It's lovely.
Isn't it? And to preserve such a marvel requires constant maintenance. Sometimes weeds creep in, and sometimes you must eradicate them, lest your garden become unkempt.
I see.
I've called the ministers here under the auspices of a reassuring gathering, but I really need to deliver what some will consider shocking news. Your presence here will go a long way to ease minds, so please, mingle. And also, keep an eye out. Any evidence of White Mantle meddlings you find would only support my actions.
I'll do some digging. And, Your Majesty, you missed a weed here.
That looks like one, but it's actually the Crichton spiderwort. It'll bloom soon, and its petals give you the most luscious dyes. It's my favorite flower. It hides its true potential from most, and then blossoms into something great. Happy hunting, Commander.
So, we're going to weed out, what's the word I'm looking for? Find the traitors within the ministry by gathering all together to this unassuming, laid-back thing, and then we're going to invite a char. Yeah, that won't put tensions, raise tensions at all. Anyways, what do you have to say? So something else you need, Commander. I'm surprised you invited me here instead of Anise. Where is she? Anise is occupied, I'm afraid. As for your invitation, you're a trusted friend, and I've no doubts your presence is a welcome relief to the ministers as well. The loyal ones, anyways. Yeah, we'll see about that. I know human-char relations have been getting better over the last 250 years, but they're still not, you know, all hunky-dory, happy, fun times all around for everyone. Do you have any updates on Logan Thackeray? I'm sad to say that Logan is still recovering from his injuries. There isn't much else I am able to tell you about his recovery, but it has been slow. And since Codicus was in charge of the Ministry Guard, are you concerned about their loyalty? I most certainly am, Commander. It's why I need you here. So, if they try anything, I get to smash them. So, let's run around. I guess we get to play politics again.
There's always time to talk.
But you don't have anything to say. Minister Estelle, what do you have to say? Excuse me, I couldn't help notice you speaking to the Queen. How is she? Pillar of strength under pressure, as always. Oh, that's good to hear. With everything that's happening, I worry for her, for us. Yes, the White Mantle are beyond despicable, aren't they? Quite. Power-hungry mongrels with nothing more than gold in their eyes. Indeed. Or as Ziltoid would say it, indeed. That was a terrible Ziltoid impression. I've stepped on things with more moral authority than those poisonous toads. It's very clear how you feel about the White Mantle. Your friend Codicus' association with them must have rattled you. I can tell you, no one was more shocked. I hadn't the faintest idea. Really, even with all the rumors circulating before he broke out? Oh, I try to ignore gossip. People caught spreading such filth earn a trip to the gallows. Should earn a trip to the gallows. I feel the same way about traitors. They should watch their necks. Good day. Let's see. Let's talk to... There's a
I'm
bunch
surprised
of
people. The Wee family has the guts to show their faces after what their daughter has done.
Oh, don't be cruel. Minister Wee wouldn't abandon his duties.
Yes, but treason against the Queen. That's a lot of shame to bear.
It is, but we do well to ignore Valette's mistakes and recognize his commitment to the position.
Well, well, well. Hello, guard. How can I help you, Commander? Have you seen anything suspicious? Me. No, but we have been on high alert as of late. Our legate minister Kotakis converted to the White Mantle, as you know, and that has reflected poorly on us. Do you suspect anyone among the guard to be sympathetic to Kotakis? I have heard that ministry guards in the past have betrayed Kareta, but now, here at this gathering? No way, Commander. Our men are loyal to Queen Jennah. The opposite of Dirty Jennah. To Queen Jennah. That's why we are here. That's why they are here. How can you be so sure? Honestly, I guess I can't be. But I promise to keep an eye out for anything suspicious. Good to hear. Let's talk to Minister Artun. How may I be of service to the commander this evening? What are your thoughts on tonight's gathering of ministers? I can't help but feel a bit uneasy during these difficult times. I suspect the large number of guards present are the Queen's way of reassuring us ministers, but their presence has me anxious. What do you make of the extra security measures? The Queen always has our best interests in mind. Of this, I have no doubt. You speak highly of her. Are the two of you close? Her Majesty has guided me through turmoil in the past and illuminated some harsh truths about traitors whom I once called friends. She has my fullest confidence. Thank you for your time. Well, that doesn't sound good.
Stupid piece of junk. This is unbelievable.
Did you break the gate? Did you break the gate? The golem's broken.
What happened? The White Mantle?
Calm down, calm down. Third time this week this old guy's gone.
It's on fire now.
I have to manually enter manifest data when he's offline. Can you... Would you mind getting him up and running while I keep the gate's records?
Sure.
What a sport. And do be quick about it. My hand cramps easily.
Oh no!
This is an odd method of repair.
He can be a bit finicky, but the fix-it interface, or fixture case I've created, should make it clear what he needs in order to be fixed. Do you think that'll catch on? I was also toying with combining display and repair into disrepair. Oh, my. Never said that aloud.
So it looks like I get to sit here and go do different things when he's on fire or freezing or electrocuted. So! You're on fire, Golem. You're overheated. Now you're overcooled. Now you're overheating. Am I fixing it?
No. You can't repair him until you break him out of his malfunctioning loop.
Okay. So... Aha. Now... Okay. Now you're on fire. Now you're cold. Now you're electrocuted! It's like Simon says. Did I win? Did I win? Fix the golem. Oh no, you're doing the thing again! Stop doing the thing. No, that's the wrong thing.
The fixture case has three main functions, each specifically designed to counteract the golem's bugs. Their features. Use the correct function to counteract his current state. Do it enough and it'll break him out of his malfunctioning loop.
Um Okay. Okay. Did I win?
Thanks. When you retire from dragon slaying, you should think about opening your own golem repair shop. No one came in or out, so I didn't end up needing to man the gate locks. Plus, I needed the break.
Glad I could do your job for you. By the way, I found this part, but didn't know where it went. Looks a little like...
I've never seen that before. I don't know what it is, but it's not part of this golem.
Huh. Hey, Timmy.
I'm here.
Is the communication device you gave me one of a kind?
Probably not. I mean, mine is by far the best and most advanced, but there are others out there. Wait, why do you ask?
I found a device that looks a lot like the communicator. If it was planted here by the White Mantle, they could be listening in. I'm guessing it isn't the only one.
Ooh, if you want, I can use your communicator to send out a high-frequency ping that'll help you find any others in your area.
Let's do that. I'll get what I can and show the Queen.
Oh, be sure to let her know I helped.
Okay, this Asura, he's the best Asura. He's so far the only person in this entire game that has pronounced Golem properly, as far as I'm concerned. Anyway, so what are we doing? Communicator ping. Detect direction. In proximity of, other comm signals. Blue ping is far away, yellow ping is nearby, red ping is very close. So, let's go talk to more people since I was interrupted from that. What was all that commotion, Commander? Is everything all right? Everything is fine. The gate golem was acting up, that's all. I pity that golem's attendant. I don't envy his position. It is, however, good to see you at a time like this. Do you have a reason to distrust anyone at this meeting? The people who cross over, it could be anyone. People we would never expect. Like your daughter? Yes, Valette made a horrible mistake. We are devastated, as you can imagine, but our daughter's actions are not our own. Your association with Valette raises suspicions about your allegiances. The Queen has no reason to be concerned, and neither do you. My wife and I have always worked for the betterment of Kryda. Indeed. Yeah, I don't think they're going to be very suspicious, because, if I recall correctly, Lady Wee plays involved with the Order of Whispers. And thus probably isn't involved with the White Mantle. Unless she is. In which case, the Order of Whispers might have a problem to deal with as well. Shining Blade! The commotion had us a bit shocked. Spooked, Commander. Anything to report? I'm investigating some suspicious devices that may be hiding around here. Devices? What sort of devices? That is unsettling news, Commander. What can we do to support you? Be on high alert, although I suspect you already are. I think I can speak for the Shining Blade when I say, I'm glad you're with us here, Commander. I'm honored. Looks like you've got plenty of support from the Ministry Guard. Indeed, there are a lot of ministry guards here, but this is a meeting of the ministry, so I suppose it makes sense. Still, something about it has me on edge. On edge? How so? The Shining Blade takes an oath to protect the throne and Kryda above all. The ministry guards, however, pledge their allegiance to the legate minister, to Cauticus. Do you think any ministry guards could still hold allegiance to that traitor? I have my suspicions. No proof, but I certainly have my suspicions. Have you seen any suspicious activity among the Ministry Guard recently? I haven't, but I'm not so foolish to think that just because I don't see it, it's not there. These traitors are cunning, and we have to remain vigilant. I have more questions. Is there anyone here you are particularly suspicious of? I'd rather not point any fingers or risk a false accusation. Suffice to say, I'm keeping an eye out. You should tell me now. Well, I'm surprised to see Estelle is still part of the ministry after she was caught lying about official matters. I know the Queen pardoned her, but, well, I just can't trust her. Not again. Yeah, she was being a bit... She came off as a bit iffy. Farron, what are you doing here? You goof. Off to save the day again, Commander? How am I not surprised to see you running toward the source of an explosion? I have a knack for finding trouble! What brings you to this ministry meeting? Oh, he's my plus one! I don't want to be the only minister to come without a guest. Plus, I like to keep some muscle around during these dangerous times. I see. I could never turn down the lady's invitation, should the White Mantle dare show their faces? Swordmaster Farron will put them in their place. Have you seen anything suspicious this evening? Thankfully, no, but I have been rather busy chatting with Minister Marula. That's nice. Oh, Farron, don't let me distract you all evening. I think I should get going. Farron is being Farron. Lady Gwyneth, what do you have to say?
I'm rich, you know.
I don't care. I don't want to talk to you. I heard the commotion. Is everything all right, Commander? Ah, yes, nothing to worry about. Are you here on behalf of Minister Cotticus? I am. The people of Beetleton still need a voice within the Ministry, and I am committed to ensuring that we maintain good relations despite Cotticus's treason. You must have worked closely with Cotticus. For a time, yes. Since he converted to the White Mantle, he has abandoned us, so it has been a long time since I saw him. Do you and the people of the Shire still hold any sympathies for him? Of course not. We were ashamed to have ever called him our leader. He has turned his back on Krita and on the gods themselves. Good to know. Who else is around here to talk to before I start pinging my locator and going beep, beep, beep?
It's unnatural to see the Queen wandering around without him lately.
Joke's on you, ladies. Logan got busted up pretty bad in the whole dragon thing. I don't think there's anyone else to talk to. I think it was just a case of hit up everyone who I hadn't yet hit up before the golem went. There's a thing there. It just shows... Is it just showing me on the map because I took too long to actually go find it? Queen, what you doing over here? You don't got nothing to say. Yes, I'm close. I know I am close. Because it's telling me it's right over here. Wait, let's do the red ping! There it is. It's a doohickey. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we done made a mess. So, that was fun. Well, I suppose we shall, Oh, no, there's still one more person I have to question for an optional thing. Where is the last person to question for the optional thing? Oh, they're up there. Okay. And it would be... just random minister. Not even a named minister.
Always have time to talk.
Is that golem acting up again? That silly thing exploding during our ministry meeting last week. Yes, it is, but it shouldn't give you any more trouble. That's good to hear. Is there something else you need? I'm just checking in. How do you feel about tonight's gathering? It's not wholly uncommon for the Queen to request a meeting, but given the circumstances, I'm a bit concerned. What circumstances? Well, surely you are aware of the detestable betrayal by our own legate minister. He has been missing for some time, so I hear. I am aware. I am quite aware. Did you ever work closely with Cotticus? Cotticus and I only ever met in an official capacity. Aside from spotting him at the official occasional party, we rarely interacted. I see. Do you have any reason to suspect anyone has sympathies for him? I don't mean to spread gossip, but there were rumors that Minister Arton was colluding with the White Mantle prior to Cotticus's defection. As I understand it, he and the Legate are close friends. Arton. Tisk tisk, you old stinker. The Queen seems to trust Minister Arton, though. Why don't you? Well, I suppose bad reputation can be difficult to overcome. That may be unfair of me, but I have a hard time trusting anyone during times like these. I understand. Thank you for your time. But do you trust yourself? Alright, let's go play the sonar pinging game. If I had to guess, there's a book. I bet that's the thing. Of course it's the thing. Ping. Oh look, another security spark. Go, Violent Ministry Guard. Fight it for great justice. Well, alright, that's two doohickeys down. Let's go find us the last one. Eeny, meeny, miny, moe. Which way did it go? We're getting close. Oh, it's right over here. And here we go one more time. I stopped my thing before it was done. Oops! Alright, let's smash this up.
Anger rising. Moving out.
So it seems counterintuitive. We were just talking about how beautiful this garden is, and now I'm setting parts of it on fire.
To back up whatever the queen's about to do, I should give these to her.
Queen, I found thingamajigs! Let the suspicions commence!
Commander, I was just trying to reassure the Wees here. It's a stressful time for them. Well, not just them, for everyone.
The Queen is politely dancing around the fact that our daughter is on the wrong side of this.
Have you heard from her? At all?
We haven't heard from Belette. That doesn't mean we won't. She's a good girl, Commander. Just a little lost. She'll find a way home. We only want to hear her play the violin again.
We all do, Minister.
May we speak a moment, Your Majesty?
Of course.
Pardon us.
I found these listening devices around the courtyard. They could be White Mantle.
Thank you, Commander. I needed evidence like this to support my stance. It appears this is an opportune time, then. Allow me to excuse myself. I have a speech to give.
Plot twist, it's not actually the White Mantle. It's actually... the Imperial Inquisition! I would say nobody expects the Imperial Inquisition, but usually everybody expects the Imperial Inquisition to show up at some point.
Ministers and members of the Royal Court, for years we've had a fester inside the kingdom, a creeping undertow that sucked some of our friends and family into its darkness. Now, with Confessor Codicus at the White Mantle's helm, this seething conflict will soon come to a head, as we are poised to be smashed between two rising elder dragons. We cannot stand for a threat from within. For this reason, I'm hereby suspending the ministry until the danger has passed. Some of you will understand it's for your safety. Others will understand that I have trapped them here, far from the White Mantle's network.
You cannot! I won't be treated like a common doliac, herded into a pen and kept as livestock. I am no criminal. You claim this will keep us safe. From what? Who will keep us safe from you, I say?
Good Minister, this measure is temporary, I assure you. Only until the kingdom is safe from attack and the traitors in our midst have revealed themselves. The commander has already
verified... There is no attack. This is an autocrat's ploy. Fellow ministers, this is a moment in life, a rare moment where you will look back one day and say, I made a stand or I did nothing. Do you silently let the Queen capture your voice and the voice of the people? Or do you make enough noise that the six gods themselves hear us say nay when my grandfather...
exploded? So much for that, there is no attack nonsense. Well, this guard's a traitor.
We have to get you to safety.
We need to secure the ministers. The loyal ones, at least.
I'll try to take care of them, but you're my priority.
All right. Oh, there's a bunch of shit going on up here. Let's make a mess. Nobody likes you, Jade Armor. You ruined my blast combo. Now you will die. Cue random minister. Minister guard, minister. Alright. This is politics that I like. So I wonder if we have any of the named people I was just talking to went all turncoat in this mess here. Or if it's just like guards and unnamed ministers. I guess we'll find out. You're dead.
We've prepared for many contingencies. There are some defenses ready to set up right outside the chamber. Quickly!
Who are you? Minister guard. Get squashed. Minister!
More white mantle incoming.
Ooh! Good! Targets! Let's set him on fire! Alright, here we go. More fire! Fire for everyone! How many targets are there? All I hear are people dying. Cleric! Kill the cleric! Hey! Nobody likes you, White Mantle Knight. I just sit here doing all this and I think. Oh. Oh man, that looked like it might have hurt. Where did all these people come from? Stop with the knockback! No, you will not do that nonsense. Where is Queen Jennah? Just running around in this mess getting shot at. Come on. There we go. Alright. Jennah, you need healing. That is not your cue to run and immediately aggro somebody else before your auto heal kicks in. Oh, that's his whale. I thought that said wait. Hey! There'll be none of that. Oh man, this is gonna be a long video. Ha ha, you burned down before you could do your little thing. Are we out of people to murder for the moment? No, here come more mantle flunkies. You idiots! Okay, oh good, Jennah is following me. Good, that means I can run away and make her auto-heal kick in. Good.
Great. Another mesmer.
Well, of course.
Smash away, Commander.
The politics of smashing! And now I sit here doing this and I just think, man, if only American politics were more like this, the 2016 election would have been a lot more interesting. And that's all I'm going to say about that probably ever. Oh man. Alright, people. You there, minister, with the things on your face.
Good. Then to the throne. Easily defend it.
The last one is just outside
there. I'm losing health. And now I have health back. You know, if she's following me, I bet I can just run away and... Excuse me. Where am I going now? Up here. Here, let's pick this dead guy up. Rise, dead guy. Jennah, help with the rezzing.
Shake it off.
I stepped in fire and I caught on fire. So, I'm going to not get into every single fight. Except for these guys who are going to show up and go, ho 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 ho. And nobles just standing there like, nah, white men are attacking, garden's on fire, I'ma just stand here until somebody walks up and swats me. Somebody just threw something at me. Ah, speaking of the Inquisition, here's a White Mantle Inquisitor, who apparently decided they didn't want to actually fight me after throwing something at me. Who's left? Nobody's left. Get up, guard! Alright. So what's gonna come try to kill us now? That guy. That guy right there.
Jennah. That's enough. Fellow ministers, join me and help the White Mantle rid Kryta of this illegitimate ruler. Or stand by her side and be judged by my fire.
Estelle, what a surprise. Who could have seen this coming?
Me.
You?
Me.
You're dead.
Maybe you.
You're dead.
Did you?
You're dead.
And you, my friend, were you surprised?
Run away!
Get back here, you! I hate to break it to you, but I won't run as easily. I was
Ogan!
Codicus tapped me for the job of regicide, and I will see it to its bloody end.
Not on my watch, Estelle.
Logan!
Captain Thackeray, beyond brave as always, but I need you leading the defense of the city. I'll handle this bloated tick.
Handle me? You can't move! This hamstrung doormat is your only hope, and I'm about to kill him, just to put him out of his lovesick misery.
Estelle!
What? The whole ministry knew it.
You'll regret that slight.
Damn you!
And now I will pound you into paste!
Prepare to strike.
Well, that was unpleasant. Alright, Estelle, time for you to be, like, on fire. And dying. What is this blocking nonsense? You had a break bar. And then I removed it. You had a break bar. And then I removed it. And now you're on fire again. A new build will be available in 10 minutes. Well, shit, I'd better hurry up and finish this. Did they already break something on patch day? Oh, just get wrecked already. Oh, wrong button. Stop with your giant swirly space toilet. Now you're dead.
That's the last of them, then. For now.
That was an impressive show, Your Majesty.
It was. How do you like smashing things to solve your problems?
I never want to take up arms against one of my subjects, but I think I might be quite suited for your lifestyle.
I'll save you a spot in Dragon's Watch if you ever decide to step down.
Very kind. Now, what's the situation outside the city?
The White Mantle army is making a push from the lake, but we don't know the full extent of their numbers. I'm headed down to set up a command tent at Doric's Landing.
It's good to see you on your feet again. I'll meet you there.
Great. We could use the help. Talk to Lieutenant Fors in the Plaza of Lyssa. I'll make sure you're granted access to the battlefield.
Logan, please don't slow your recovery by doing something like getting yourself killed. Commander, thank you. And watch out for the weeds.
Well, alright, ladies and gentlemen, that looks like that is going to be it for the first part of The Head of the Snake. Oh, before I accept that, there's probably a master I'm going to have to use. There is. Spectral Aid. What does this do? Ancient magic still linger in the world of Tyria, and those especially attuned to them can sometimes call on them in times of need. Great need. Okay, stuff. I don't have any mastery points to train it once I get it, though, but whatever. All right!
Greetings.
Logan, what you got to say? Thank you for protecting the Queen when I couldn't. I'm happy to help. How are you feeling? Recovery has been slow. The blighting pod changed me. Not my mind, but my body feels different. It's good to see you, Logan. I was worried. Don't worry about me, Commander. We have a war to fight. The White Mantle are pushing into Divinity's reach from the east. Are there civilians that will need our aid? Probably. A great many of them, and all at the mercy of the White Mantle. They will need our full support, and we should go at once. I'll see you soon. Queen says, thank you for your assistance. It's unfortunate that we had to deal with Estelle, but she left us little choice. It was my pleasure to smash things and bring the traitor to justice. I have to admit that it was exhilarating to see some action again, but I'm sure my advisors would prefer I don't make a habit of it. With the White Mantle threat so close, you should stay under heavy guard. Will you and Logan handle our White Mantle threat to the east? I will do everything I can to ensure you have the full support of the Seraph. Thank you, Your Majesty. Stay safe. Alright. Well, that appears to be it. Now, I could probably wander back out here. Yeah, there's a Watch Knight. I didn't know they were still making use of those. I thought trash those after the whole Scarlet incident. I got an achievement for talking to the cat out in the middle of... Okay. Lady Wee, do you have anything to say?
Oh, I didn't see you there.
You didn't see me there. I'm just wasting more time wandering around. Nobody probably has anything to say, but, you know, at least you got to watch me run out and... Farron! You must have something to say. Nope. Okay, nobody probably has anything to say, so now I'm just wasting time. As is par for the course, this is already going to be a long video. That looks like Artin. He's dead. Minister Wee. The other Minister Wee. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, that is going to be it for the first part of Head of the Snake. I lost my train of thought. Anyways, as always, I thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this this first part to the return to the Guild Wars 2 Living Story. The politics are much better than the last time we did politics in Guild Wars. We They actually got to smash things this time, which is fun. As always, if you enjoyed this video, now I've blown my whole spiel. I have to remember. Okay, yeah, I hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching. Got that. As always, if you have any suggestions or recommendations for games that you think I should play that might make for a good series in the future, in between when Guild Wars is not doing story updates, because I have to fill that space between it with something, because, you know, I can't run a channel off of just having videos for a week for, you know, every three months. Or if you just give me a shout and give me some feedback, let me know how I'm doing. Am I doing good? Am I doing bad? If I'm doing bad, what can I do to go from doing bad to doing good? Or if you just wish to inform me that I am a terrible person because, I don't know. Because politics, we'll just blame it all on politics this time. You may do so in the comment box below. PC and PS4 only for gaming suggestions, as that's all that I can currently record on. And as always, if you enjoyed this video and would like to see more, please consider subscribing to my channel. That way you will be kept up to date whenever I post a new video. And then you won't have to miss out on any of the shenanigans that go down in this my little corner of the internet. Also, if you know of anyone else who might enjoy watching this sort of thing, please do me a favor and share this or one of my other videos with them. That way they may potentially be pointed in my general direction, and then they might swing by and be entertained by the shenanigans that go down in this my little corner of the internet. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, once again, I thank you all for watching. I hope you are enjoying this return to the Guild Wars story. I'm NanoElite666. I'm going to go get this video all set up to render, and hopefully we won't have problems like I did with the last story chapter. And I'll get this part up today on launch day, which should have been yesterday, but you know, there was arena that had problems with snowstorms and knocking out power, and it screwed up everything on their end, so they had to delay the launch. But I'm still going to get it up on the day it went live. Or at least I'm going to try. God forbid something doesn't happen. Anyways, I'm NanoElite666, and I will see you all next time.